Hello, this is Jake from the Corona team, and in the next few minutes, you'll be able to use the new tone mapping tools to get exactly the look you're after. Tone mapping now comes in a configurable stack of operators so you can add, delete, and move them as you require. We can find the tone mapping stack in the virtual frame buffer under post. The default stack consists of simple exposure, which will control the overall exposure of the image. We've got our white balance, tint, contrast, and saturation. The ASOS output transform is a new operator we can see in the stack, and it's basically a one-click ASOS film look. So if you're looking for that film-like ASOS look, then this is for you. We can see by just switching it on, we get a really nice filmic tone mapped image. And it's really simple, just turn it on. And normally in these overexposed areas, we'd have to do some highlight compression, but with the ASOS OT, that's no longer the case. New operators can be added using the plus button. And notice that highlight compress is now known as Reinhardt highlight compression, and filmic highlight and shadows can now be found under filmic mapping. Operators are applied from top to bottom, and we can move them around by clicking and dragging, and the checkbox on the left allows us to turn them on and off. And we can also delete operators by right-clicking and clicking on delete. Because the stack is completely customizable, we can add as many operators as we like. We can add other lookup tables, and we can change the opacity to what we please. While you can use this to blend results of LUTs together, as we've seen, it can also be a handy way of storing two or three of your favorite LUTs and then just switch on the ones we want when it comes time for saving, rather than having to keep changing them via the dropdown. We can also see this big old preset button down here, and we can select any of the presets. And just be aware that this will remove the current setup. So if we wanted to save our parameters, we can click on the save button and then use load to load it up later. So let's choose warm cinematic. And with each of these, you may need to adjust the exposure, as the exposure depends on the light conditions in our scene. We can also have a play with the contrast, and pretty quickly, we've got some nice tone mapping. So far, all the tone mapping has been applied globally. We can use a camera override to apply unique tone mapping to certain cameras. So let's select our camera. And under tone mapping, we can see that we've got an override checkbox. And when we turn that on, notice the camera's name appears at the top of the stack. Now we can make the tone mapping changes independent for this camera. Then notice when we jump back to the perspective view, the global tone mapping is applied. And then back to the camera, the override is applied. And this can be really helpful when we have interior and exterior shots in the same scene we want to render that would require very different exposures. And finally, if we'd like to use photographic exposure instead of simple exposure, we can add it in the stack, move it to the top, and delete our simple exposure. This then gives us control of the f-stop, shutter speed, and ISO. As you can see, tone mapping gives us the power and flexibility of tone mapping without having to leave the virtual frame buffer. And we look forward to seeing what you create, and make sure to check out our other videos to keep exploring what Corona can do for you.